previous video, we learned about the jump, that is the program control operation, and now we're going to talk about the master control relay activation and deactivation. Master control relay means it's like a main switch in our house. Okay, when that main switch is deactivated, there is no effect on all the switches or the lights, everything will be turned off. That is a master control. So it's like a main switch. So for getting that master control, you can go for the additional instructions over here. And you can go for the master control activate MCRA. This is the first one we have to initialize, have to place right here. MCRA, I don't have to put any contact right here, just simply place the MCRA. And on the next thing, MCR less than simple, that means open the MCR ranges wherever that master control range should be started, or at which point we have to start the master control activation. So I just placed a contact also, that will be I0.0. So this is my master control range starting place. From here the master control is getting started, and I just placed one more thing, that will be a contact and coil. That is the thing I have to skip over, that is the sub programs. So I0.1, that will be activating the queue 0.0. So my master control can determine the range of my master control. I can close the master control range right here. If you want to add too much rungs, you can do it. So I'm just going to close my master control range. Here you can see closes the master control range. So I just use the close the master control range. I don't want that contact right now. Just only two contacts for the master control range starting, and my program, and for my program also. So no contacts required for the master control activation. That is the MCRA, master control, or enable the master control range. And I can also put one more thing, that the master control deactivate or disable the master control range. That also requires no contacts, just simply placed. So now you can see I'm just enabling, making it bigger. Sorry, like this. Bigger one, and now hope you can see all these whole things. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, fine. So now I go into the runtime, download this stuff. Here we can go for the monitoring mode. Okay, now we're gonna close all these steps, deactivating all the outputs, and you can see now we're gonna talk about the master control. And here is the master control activation. That means I0.1 will be activating the master control, and my program is I1 will be energizing Q0. See, I1 is activated and Q0 is no longer on. See, in this picture, in this simulation, not only in the simulation, here you can see here the power is actually activating, you can see the green line, but the coil is not activated, it's in the blue color. Let me try, I'll be turning on the master control. See, I0.0 master control is now activated, and the coil also turns green. Then we get the output Q0.0. That is the master control activation. When I deactivate my master control, see, my coil turns blue. That means the output goes off. That is the master control activation and deactivation. So that's it. It will be working like a main switch. Okay, when the main switch is on, we get the power in my house. When the main switch is off, all the power will be gone in between the master control, range. That's the master control relay activation, just like a program control, just like we learned, like the jump. Jump is for the deactivation or temporary disablement. Master control is permanent.